Welcome back to another Tua Tagovailoa and the Miami Dolphins content. Man, it's been busy. We've been really, really busy. Took a break and then, you know, school still on, family, everything. And now school is back and vacation is over. So we are back and getting ready for the Dolphins new season. But before we do that, let's address that last week when that Ryan Clark, you know, I mean, really Ryan Clark. I was ready to jump in, but I said, you know what? There was a lot of people who were angry at you, you know, because everybody used to be angry at Tua, you know, and nobody protected Tua, you know. I mean, literally the whole world was jumping on Tua until Tua proved last year that he's worthy. Ever since Mike McDaniel came in, Tua has been more confident. In fact, he is so confident this year. It just showed. But let's just make sure we hear what happened. So so last week, Ryan Clark was on a Monday Night Football. This is what he said about Tua. You know, actually, he thought it was a joke, but it's no joking matter. So this is what he actually said.
Tell you what he wasn't doing. He wasn't in the gym. I bet you that.
Come on, he wasn't with me.
He might have spent a lot of time at the tattoo parlor. He was not at the dinner table eating what the nutritionist had advised.
So I guess he felt like he needed to be making jokes. And, you know, now that he's got a new contract, you know, and moved up and, you know, a lot of his former colleagues had been like let go, you know, no jobs. And now that he has a better job now, maybe making more money, he can be funny, I guess. And he even went so far as to calling Tua like a stripper in a bar out there in named Onyx or something in Atlanta.
Yeah, he's built like a girl work at Onyx in Atlanta right now on the bottom.
Come on now.
Get to the show. I'm
sorry. Am I allowed to ask?
So, you know, I mean, this is what they did. Always did, you know, in 2020, 2021. But, you know, people have been fighting back, you know, and standing up for Tua, you know, and because there were just a lot of like really negative things said about Tua. And, you know, here's the one guy who always stood up for Tua ever since the very beginning. Yeah. Do you have it? Yeah. Okay. Oh, I'm sorry, man. We just jump right into the content without introducing you. And here is the big European Tagovailoa supporter.
Oh, thank you very much. No problem. I got it here. I put it up for you.
But I like the sauce from Tua there in response. Yeah. I loved everything about it. AJ, your thoughts?
Yeah, I like it too. I mean, you could tell Tua is very like measured, calculated in what he wants to say. Like, he wants to say a lot more, obviously, but he's smart enough not to. But how Ryan Clark was like attacking his offseason workouts and his nutrition? I don't understand that. How do you know exactly what he was?
Yeah, so you see, Tua finally stood up and said something, you know, and that was because he didn't even know what was going on until somebody during one of his press conference asked him if he had heard of what Ryan Clark said, and you know, he answered, and he was very polite, and then you know he was trying not to, you know, disrespect the guy, you know, that's what he was trying to do.
Normal.
But he finally let it out, and yeah. You know, and I think a lot of us are really
absolutely
happy that he said something. You know,
very happy.
He didn't
very
go
happy
overboard. No. He just said exactly what needed to be said, and this is what Tua just at the very end, after being trying to be very polite,
I finally said this.
Yeah, I want it to be a little lighter. There's a mixture of things that people don't understand, that people don't know about, that are talked about, that go behind the scenes. So, you know, I'd appreciate if you kept my name out your mouth.
That's yes, Tua. That's it, Tua.
Very
all
good
the way,
we are
Tua.
Very proud,
proud
Tua
of you. Proud yes, of standing up, man.
Proud.
Man, that's the whole thing, man. And Tua finally stood up, you know. And yes. And, you know, there's a reason why he's bulky. He even looks like a rugby player. That I love that. Rugby, he looks like a rugby player.
Of course,
he?
Of course. That he really looks like a rugby player.
Oh, yeah. And he's doing everything. I mean, you know, the tattoos on his arm with his culture, his Samoan background, you know, it has a lot of meaning. And we won't go into that today, but we will do sooner or later. But, you know, jiu-jitsu, so that he's able to fall, you know. I mean, that's the thing he's been practicing on. He's been working on, you know. And so I'm really glad that he said that and he's standing up for himself. And a lot of people are happy that he's calling him out, you know. And that's the Tua that has grown up. You know, he's that showing his leadership quality now. Absolutely. You know, it's coming out. But that's to be expected. Yeah, you know, he's absolutely going on his fourth year.
Oh, I love it. Here, I play what the Ryan Clark said.
If I've offended you, Tua, if I've hurt you, if I've disrespected you, if anybody that supports and loves you feels some sort of way because of what I said, I truly apologize.
All right, man. So there it is. Just apologize is all we are saying. And then you did. And because you were a former teammate of Troy Polamalu,
that is right. Apologies, okay, accepted.
You know? I mean, you know, that Hall of Famer you played with, you know, back at Pittsburgh, you know, one of your favorite teams there, isn't it?
Well, of course, I was of Ben Roethlisberger, you know, that is why. But I'm a Tua Tagovailoa fan with the Miami Dolphins. I'm here to make sure that nobody is bothering him. You know what I mean.
So I hear you. And that's why we're here, to make sure that that people, you know, watch. You know, he's been not... And I think it has something to do with his background, that he's coming from a place where no one has ever seen someone so successful from the islands, and you know, Tua from Hawaii, and you know, and background as a Samoan, you know, and people didn't expect that, but he's doing really well, and and he will have a great year this year. And speaking of this year, here are the 53 members of the 2023. How do you call
this?
It? Our new cast. Just the roster here for 2023, our new season. And here are the 53, you know. And it's sad to see some of them let go, but that's the business part. And you know, something you have to realize, that maybe some of the people that have been cut, you know, some of them will be put back after today, on Wednesday. After Wednesday, they'll be put back to make sure that they are in the team. In the practice squad. Okay, so here are some of the people. Here's the offense.
Okay, right. So put it up. You want to say something about the list?
Of course. A shout out to I got this actually from Joe Schad from the Palm Beach Post. So shout out. If you haven't, go check it out. Just type it in. You know, he put the list, so I just kind of like, you know, made it easier for everybody to see. So check it out. Okay, so here it is, right here at quarterback. So, you know, of course, Tua Tagovailoa is in blue, Mike White, Skylar Thompson, you know, and then the running back, I mean, you know, Miles Gaskin, maybe he comes back in the squad, you know. So that would be the one that we would watch out for. You know, you have six running backs out there. The wide receivers, everyone is in there. You know, Tyreek Hill, Jalen Waddle, Braxton Berrios, Cedric Wilson. You know, there's not the tight end, maybe. Tight end, Torrance Smythe, Tyler Croft, and the offensive line. Now, as you can see the list, there's one over here who's traded. I guess it's Dan Feeney. He'll be traded to the Chicago Bears. So, you know, it's kind of tough to put a list like this, because you know some of the players have worked really hard, you know, to be in the team, but you know, they only have enough room, you know, for 53 people. So here is the defense.
Okay, I put it up. Where it is? Here it is.
Yeah, see, I love this. Number 94 is there. Christian Wilkins, man. You know, I'm really glad he showed up. Okay, so that's a big surprise for today. He's there. And, you know, one person. I mean, as you can see, you have your five there: Christian Wilkins, Raycon Davis, Zach Zeeler, Emmanuel Ogba, Brandon Pili. Brandon Pili, man. Oh, Brandon Pili. Can I tell you something about Brandon Pili, man, from Alaska? He's part Samoan, Alaskan native, mixed there. But I was watching his sister playing basketball during the NCAA tournament because she moved from USC and played for Utah, you know. So what a great story for Brandon Pili, undrafted, man, you know. And he made the team, man. He's on the defensive line, and he's a good player, really.
Very, very good.
I mean, what a kid. You know, there's three of them that were undrafted and got picked. You know, so unbelievable. You know, unbelievable that the Miami Dolphins always find gems. You know, so linebackers. Yeah, you have all the seven here, and your cornerbacks. There's seven, and here's the one thing that a lot of people didn't know: Noah Igbinoghene has been traded to the Cowboys, so he's no longer there. So the rest of the team, yeah, it looks pretty cool, man. You know, so this is what we have for you guys, and then I'm glad we're finally slowly making content again, and we'll do more as we get ready for the game week one.
Yeah.
So if you're here for the first time, make sure you subscribe to the channel as we slowly get back on schedule here. And thank you, everybody. Sorry it took us a long break, but we needed to do that. And we'll talk to you on our next content. Everybody, talk to you later. Take it easy.